Hi, this is Dr. A. In our fourth and last video on introduction to medical terminology, we're going to introduce confidentiality and pharmacology. Okay, so any information or record that's relating to a patient is privileged information that you may not share, okay? You have a moral and legal responsibility to keep it all private. You can only discuss patients' private information with other healthcare workers that are directly involved in their care and that need to know this information in order to give proper care to the patient. Proper authorization must be signed by a patient before any information can be released, and that authorization generally states who can have access to that information. So oftentimes it might be a spouse or a child or children or parents, depending on the situation, and they have to be listed on this form, and it's often called a HIPAA form for the act that it refers to, which is the Health Insurance Portability and Accountability Act that was passed in 1996, and it sets federal standards to protect records. Okay, but what I really want you to understand is if you violate a patient's confidentiality, whether it's on purpose or not, and you are caught and they find you guilty of violating this act, then it's a felony because you violated federal law, and felons can't practice healthcare. Like, the healthcare facilities will not hire felons, so that a breach of confidentiality can completely lock you out of the career that you worked really hard to get. So it is really, really important to respect confidentiality. An example of a breach of confidentiality would be, for example, you see somebody you know, a friend, or maybe somebody you don't like. So this happened, I'll give you an example. A person that I know that got the felony and can't work in healthcare anymore. She saw her soon-to-be ex-husband's girlfriend at a clinic, and she accessed those records even though she had no business accessing those records to see why she was there for, and found out she was pregnant. And so she knew this information, and that's how she got caught, because she wasn't supposed to know because it wasn't public, but she knew it. And so they were able to trace her digital footprint, her access into the electronic health record, and see that she went into areas that she shouldn't even have been in that record because she was not part of the patient's care. And so there, she got slapped with a fine and felony, and she got fired, and she can't work in healthcare anymore. So be very careful as where you wonder. You have to have a legitimate reason to be in any parts of the patient's records or charts, but also be careful what you say, especially if you're in public areas, in elevators or in hallways. All right, so let's talk a little bit about pharmacology. So pharmacology is the study of the origin, characteristics, and effects of a drug. Drugs can come from many sources and may be natural or synthetic. If they're natural, they'll be coming from foods, animal, plants, or fungi. If they are synthetic, they will be artificially developed in a laboratory. Drugs have three names. They have a chemical name, a generic name, and a brand name. The chemical name is the description of the chemical formula. The generic name is the official name of the drug. And the brand name is the manufacturer's unique trademark name for the drug. So a drug name example with ibuprofen. So the chemical name is 2-P-azobutylphenylpropionic acid. The generic name is ibuprofen, but some of the brand names are Motrin, Advil, and Nupren. So that's an illustration. And so sometimes patients might refer to their medication by a brand name or sometimes by a generic name. Hardly ever anybody uses the chemical name because nobody knows the chemical names of the drugs they take. But generic and brand names can often be used interchangeably. So there are also legal classifications of drugs. So a prescription drug can only be ordered by a licensed healthcare practitioner, and it requires a written or now electronic prescription that's sent directly to the pharmacy. And in that prescription, you have instructions to the pharmacist on how to dispense the drug for the patient. An over-the-counter drug does not require a prescription, but it should be used under the advisement of a physician or a pharmacist, and it should be used as stated on the label. Drugs that are addictive or have the potential to be abused are controlled substances, and the Drug Enforcement Agency, or DEA, classifies these drugs as Schedule 1 through Schedule 5, and codeine, oxycontin, and morphine are all examples of controlled substances. And this is, you know, depending on how addictive they are. So Schedule 1 drugs have the highest potential for addiction. Examples are heroin and LSD. Schedule 2 drugs have a high potential for addiction. Examples are codeine and morphine. And Schedule 3 drugs have a moderate potential for addiction. Example is butabarbital. Schedule 4 drugs have a lower potential for addiction, such as phenobarbital and diazepam. And the Schedule 5 drugs have a low potential for addiction. So codeine, cough suppressant would be one. So how do you read a prescription if it is written? Well, for now, of course, a lot of it now is electronic, but prescriptions do use many abbreviations that are based in the Latin and Greek. The abbreviation PO means to be taken by mouth, so per oral. To be legal, a prescription must have a date, a physician's name, address, and DEA number, and their signature, and the patient's name and birth date. So now, of course, with electronic prescriptions and health records, so the physician would actually sign in to the patient's system or into the pharmacy system, however it interfaces, and the physician themselves will put all the information is because so they under their login and then that's sent. So then you have to be really careful, of course, as a physician that you don't stay logged in to systems, that you log in, do your thing, and then log back out so that nobody can access your login and do things under your name. And that really applies to any healthcare professional. Some abbreviations are common to prescriptions. So Rx is the drug prescribed. Mg is milligram. It's a unit of measure. Sig is instructions for the label. And Disp is the amount to dispense or the number of refills. And so those are some basics on drugs and prescription. And that wraps up the end of our intro to medical terminology.